I am not a ball handler, but you'll never take it from me. I am not a lockdown defender, but if your handle isn't tight, I'll take it from you. I'm not a shooter. Sag off me for half a second and I'll drop it on you. I am not an athlete. Let me get to the rim, I'll throw it down. I am not any one of these things. I am all of them. I am a player. I am Michael Conley. I work at my game.
Stay dedicated, things like that, and your time will come, and I believe that, and slowly but surely, that's how my life kind of played out.
Yeah.
So it's interesting that happened. And my dad is you know, the biggest thing I learned from my dad is preparation. You know, I was in ice tubs and ice bags and stuff like that when I was 9, 10, 11 years old, learning how to treat your body, learning how to maintain things, learning how to prepare the night before a game. You know, most kids are just going to sleep, staying up late playing video games, doing whatever. I'm in an ice tub or doing this, that, and the other, and then, you know, eating pasta, making sure I'm eating the right meals before the day of the game, not just the day of. So those things really kind of prepared me for the next level as I kept getting older and older.
How did growing up with a gold medalist affect the way you looked at success? Did the pressure ever get to you, or did it drive you forward?
Well, the pressure never got to me. I think I always expected to win. I always expected to succeed.
You did, or your dad?
I did.
Wow.
Really? I didn't expect. He didn't think that for me. It was something I already had just from being around. Being around success, you when you go into something, you're like, I'm gonna win.
Wow.
There's no way. I don't think about the opposite. Like, you don't think about what if I don't win? What if I don't make this shot? It's just all about, like, all right, we're winning tonight. How are we going to do it? You know, and that's the mindset that I had. And it was funny because in high school all the way to college, we literally, you know, we probably lost 8 games in 5 or 6 years total, going up from 9th grade up to, you know, 12th and then to college. So, and even in college, we lost 4 games and one being in the championship game. So, we were just, I was trained that way, just to think positive, think about the, how you're going to win, not how, you know, what if you fail type thing.
Right, or the fear of like, oh, we might not win.
Right.
A lot of people are stuck because they're afraid of losing.
Exactly.
Or they're afraid if they're an entrepreneur of putting out a business project that's not going to work. So they never actually even start it.
Exactly.
Because they're crippled by fear.
Exactly. I also think that, you know, like my coach once told me, Lionel Hollins said, a scared man can't win. So I always took that to heart, thinking like, if you go out there believing that you can win, believing you can be successful no matter what you do, whether it's with business on the court or, you know, in a classroom, if you believe you can do it, if you believe you and you failed, you know you gave everything you had, yeah, you had to it at that point, and you just didn't have enough.